YouTube tells us that 65.3% of the people who watch our content are not subscribed. So please subscribe.
Hi everyone, welcome to Healing Souls. So dear friends, in this reading we are going to see your predictions for the coming week. What are going to be your energy vibrations for yourself and your situations and people around you? And this is a timeless reading for all of the zodiac signs, beginning from Aries until Pisces. So if your moon sign, sun sign, rising sign is any of these, you can check the timestamps below in the comment box to see your zodiac sign. And this is a timeless reading, so whenever you happen to click on this link from that particular day for a period of say 7 to 10 days, these energies are going to be applicable for you. And by the time you'll be picking up this reading, I will be in the temple of Goddess Vaishno Devi Durga Mata. And so if you have any wish or any desire that you want me to pray for you to Goddess Vaishno Devi, you can comment it down in the comment box below so that I will be praying on your behalf, since I'm already going, by the time you pick this reading, I will be there visiting her. So wish you all the best, lots of love and best wishes. Let us begin our reading with our first zodiac sign. That is the zodiac sign of Aries, and let us see how the coming week is going to be for our Aries friends. Let us see the energy vibrations. So I feel that our Aries friends have been waiting on a new opportunity of some sorts, some kind of a clarity of mind, idea, an upgrade, a yes answers. Some of you are wishing to move, travel, waiting on a job opportunity, a love offer, and it comes to you in the coming week. Very beautiful energies for my Aryan friends. Magic is manifesting into their life, so it's a period of manifestation, a new opportunity of financial stability or stability in a relationship comes to you. So whatever you were waiting on manifest for you in the coming week. For many of my friends, this is a big destiny shift, an opportunity which is going to shift your destiny. So this opportunity that is coming to my Aryan friends is going to bring them a lot of soulful joy, overwhelming joy. This can be, for many of my friends, this can be with regard to travel. So it is possible you are traveling in the coming week, or it is possible that you get an opportunity to manifest, travel and move to another city, state or a country via a job shift or a residential move. I am sensing something of the sorts for you. Okay, so very beautiful energies for you. You have experienced a very beautiful lucky time frame in the last week already and enjoyed yourself thoroughly well with your family and friends, extended family. That's what I'm sensing. And in the coming weeks, just the start of the week, Monday, Tuesday, there is going to be an opportunity of financial upgrade that comes to you. And for some of my other friends, this is an opportunity of manifestation of a very stable, secured relationship. And for others of my friends, if you were wishing for childbirth, it is an opportunity of manifestation of childbirth. For some of my other friends, it's an opportunity of investing in a property or purchase of something that is going to be stable and secure for you. Mid of the week, your energies are that of the magician. So the law of attraction is working very strongly for you. It's how you believe, is how you manifest. So think positive so that you attract all the positive opportunities towards you. So if there was an interview that you had to give, you're going to crack the interviews, you're going to pass in the test, results are going to be in your favor. Towards the weekend, the energy of Three of Rods tells me that it is the time for you to prepare for a journey, to prepare for an expansion, to prepare for a move, to might be literal move to another city, state or a country, or to move for expansion through other you know, working with expansion over internet, or working with other countries as well, or travel, or might be, you know, building up a relationship for commitment. So something of the sort is happening. This is a time frame of a big commitment coming towards you, a yes answer from a big institute, big company, big organized government organization might be. If you were seeking commitment in your marriages, yes, it is happening for you. If you were wishing to become a spiritual healer or a teacher, that opportunity manifests for you in the coming weeks. So it is a start of something very, very blessed happening into your life. And this blessing is coming towards you from your ancestors, your deceased loved ones. Exactly. News of a birth or a new business opportunity is coming for you. Just the start of the week only, it is going to manifest for you. News of a birth for some of my friends and a new business opportunity for others. Great good fortune is manifesting into your life. Beautiful time frame for you. Surrender to divine timing. So whatever this is manifesting into your life might take a bit of time, but definitely it's a yes answer for you. So they say, sometimes divine timing may differ from your ego's timing. If a goal isn't manifesting fast enough according to your ego, be patient and trust the universal flow. Beautiful. So it is going to manifest for you in divine timing. Whatever opportunity you were waiting on is definitely for you, be it in a relationship, be it in a career, business, a profession, be it manifestation of childbirth or your good health. All in all, a very happy week for you. And I will be visiting Goddess Vaishno Devi during the time you're seeing this reading. So if you want to make a wish to Goddess Vaishno Devi, you can comment down below in the comment box. So wish you all the best, my Aries friends. Let us move forward to our next zodiac sign. That is the zodiac sign of Taurus. And let us see how the coming week is going to be for our Taurian friends. Let us see the energy vibrations. Wow, beautiful energies for my Taurian friends in the coming week. Definitely love is manifesting into their life. Oh my god, beautiful energies for you. So for my Taurian friends, they have had some kind of a rebirth in the last week. So it was a situation where you were evaluating and re-evaluating your relationship, whether you should be pursuing your relationship with the partner with whom you have a kind of a very passionate relationship, but it is more physically, you know, the relationship is more based on physical attraction, and you were in a contemplation whether you wanted to pursue this relationship or you wanted to come out of this relationship and pursue a relationship with another partner, a new offer of love that comes to you. So I do feel that in the coming week, one thing, you have surrendered your desire to control people. Might be you are very controlling in nature, or a person around you has been very controlling in nature. And in the last week, I do feel that, you know, you have given your judgment on them, or they have been passing judgments on you. And you have felt a lot of control around this relationship. In the coming week, I see very beautiful energies for you. First of all, if you're seeking this reading for love and relationship, then I see a reunion, I see a reconciliation of partners. So there is a new love manifesting. I do feel that a partner or an ex is coming back to you with a proposal of forgiveness and an offer to rework on your relationship, and this is going to bring in balance in your relationship. So start of the week, Monday, Tuesday, lovers, union, beautiful connections, harmony in all relationships. pleasurable time frame, mid of the week, Knight of Cups. This is an offer, an invitation of love, of soulful joy, of healing, of forgiveness coming from somebody. And towards the end of the week, Thursday, Friday, Saturday, Sunday, Ace of Cups, that is you feeling overwhelmed, you feeling very much loved, you are giving yourself love. And beautiful, emotionally healed week for you, my Taurian friends. So something is about to happen in this week which is going to bring you a lot of emotional joy. So for most of my friends, I do feel that you are focused on relationships and relationships healings in this week, and all of your relationships are healing in this week. So if there was a relationship that was toxic, there is going to be a kind of a reconciliation, or there is going to be a healing in that relationship in the coming week. Okay, and if you were seeking this reading with regard to work, career, business scenario, I do feel that an opportunity which was long awaited for your career advancement comes to you. This is a second chance, this is a rebirth, this is coming second time for you when you are ready with your lessons, with your experiences. And this opportunity can come to you from a Cancer, Pisces, Scorpio or a Capricorn person. And this person is very harmonious with you. This person is divine sent. And this person is going to bring this offer of a new opportunity, a passion growth for you, which can work out to be very much in your favor and which will eventually bring a lot of growth, name, fame, recognition for you. For some of my friends, this reading is around them awakening, them working on their soul, releasing their negativities and connecting with the divine realm. You are absolutely becoming spiritual in nature. So it's an offer of a spiritual growth. It is an offer of connecting with divine realm in the coming week. So you're feeling overwhelmed with the love that is being showered upon you from the spiritual realm. That's what I feel. So it is a week of a lot of stability, security and forward momentum. I do feel a Cancerian sign person becomes very evident for you, an Aquarius sign person and a Capricorn sign person is evident for you in the coming week. An older woman is evident around you, dealing or a relationship with an older woman. If this older woman was suffering in her health, it is possible that you know their health rejuvenates. Crown, honor and respect will come to you. So very, very beautiful energies for my Taurian friends in the coming week. Surrender your attachment to results. Okay, so whatever you've been doing, you need to surrender your attachments to results. So they say the formula for success is to do all you can to make things happen, then let go of the results. Holding on too tightly to a desired outcome can sabotage it. So just keep doing your services, keep doing your good and surrender your attachment to results. That's the way you are going to be given honor and respect in whatever love you're showering on the people around you. Now this older woman can be a woman bringing an opportunity of spiritual upgrade or a career upgrade for you in the coming week, or she can be your mother, mother-in-law or a woman in position that you will be dealing in the coming week. So I wish you all the best. Very, very beautiful energies for my Taurian friends. So while you will be seeing this reading, I will be visiting Vaishno Devi. So if there is a wish that you wish, from Vaishno Devi, Goddess Durga, you can write it down in the comment box below and I will be praying on your behalf since I'm going to be there while you check on this reading. So lots of love and best wishes to my Taurian friends. Enjoy yourself in the coming week. So now let's move on to the next zodiac sign, that is the zodiac sign. Let me cleanse the energy. The zodiac sign of our Gemini friends, and let us see how the coming week is going to be for our Gemini friends. So dear angels, what are the energy vibrations of the coming week? So our Gemini friends have been looking for some kind of a destiny shift. They've had a situation of heartbreak. They are looking for clarity on a certain situation, on a certain relationship also. Wishing for love and partnership, definitely. Wishing for clarity, wishing for positivity in their life, happy times, yes, answers. So let us see how the coming week is going to be for our Gemini friends. Okay, so they've given us four cards and let's take them all. So the coming week is going to bring a very, very beautiful good news for our Gemini friends. So it is a week of healing, it is a week of manifestation. So if you were waiting on the manifestation of a certain opportunity, might be for a new relationship or might be for a work scenario, or for healing, magic for someone's health or financial stability, security or manifestation, or you were waiting on an offer or an invitation of forgiveness, love from somebody, that is coming towards you in the coming week. So Monday, Tuesday itself, I see you hearing a news. This is a good news coming towards you. And there are going to be emails exchanged. There are going to be phone calls. There are going to be messages coming towards you. Some of you are going to travel, or might be somebody is traveling towards you. Your children become evident in the coming week. For many of my friends, it is a time frame of manifestation of childbirth. So if you were wishing on conception of a child or on a news of childbirth, that comes to you right at the beginning of the week, Monday, Tuesday. Or this is an opportunity of healing, or an opportunity of growth, marriage, settlement for your child that might be coming towards you. So very, very beautiful time frame for you. Some of my friends, this is an option of marriage and settlement that is coming towards you from a Taurian, from a Leo, Sagittarius, Aries person. Aquarius person is also evident over here. So I do feel that a Cancer, Pisces, Scorpio, Taurus, Leo, Sagittarius, Aries person, Aquarius person can be a person coming with this proposal towards you. And this relationship is going to turn out to be a commitment towards you. This is your yes answer. This is a week of an upgrade. This is a week of healing. If you were seeking for healings for your mother-child relationship, that is going to happen for you in the coming week. So it's a beautiful week of a lot many options and opportunities coming towards you, which are your yes answers. You are being asked to make your choice, make your which opportunity you want to manifest for yourself. In work regard also, there is a good news coming towards you, a yes answer for whatever you wanted to manifest for you. That communication is about to start for you from Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, and towards the weekend you will be given options of growth, prosperity. So beautiful time frame for you. Your mother, your partner, your children become evident in the coming week for you. So health is good. It's a time frame of daydreaming, traveling, fantasizing, and towards the weekend I see very stable energies for you. You are giving a lot of time to yourself. You are giving yourself love. You are going to parlors. You are purchasing items that you love. There is a blessing of goddess coming towards you. And work achievement, success, beautiful. So a news of an upgrade in your work area, that is heading for some of my friends. And or might be you wanted to travel, or there is a new opportunity that you wanted to manifest for yourself. Might be it came to you in June 2021 and is manifesting for you now, or might be this opportunity of change manifests for you in the month of June 2022. So it can be an opportunity of childbirth, can be an opportunity of an upgrade of a new job, career, business, or your passion. It can be an opportunity of marriage and settlement manifesting for you, and the month has been given. Surrender to your soul's path. So for some of my friends, this can be a passion that they want to pursue. So you have many options. You are jack of all, so you are being given options for you to pursue your soul path. That's the message coming across. So they say your life's journey has been perfectly designed for your soul, your soul's growth. Embrace every lesson and every moment. Beautiful energies for my Gemini friends. And also want to tell my Gemini friends that while you're seeing this reading at that particular time, I'm visiting Vaishno Devi Mata. So you can give your wishes down below in the comment box, and I'll be praying for you since I'm going to be there while you're going to be watching this reading. So I'll pray on your behalf. So I wish you all the best, lots of love and best wishes to my Gemini friends. Beautiful week ahead for our Gemini friends. So let's move on to the next zodiac sign. That is the zodiac sign of Cancer, and let us see the energy vibrations of the coming week for our Cancerian friends. So dear angels, what are the energy vibrations of the coming week for our Cancerian friends? Oh my god, the cards have been really falling out like something. Oh my god, it's a wonderful time frame for my Cancerian friends, and they've been telling me that, you know, these opportunities are manifesting in the life of my Cancerian friends because they have been believing a lot in divine. Their subconscious mind believes in divine, although they often keep pretending and keep saying that we don't believe in anything, but their subconscious mind is positive and they do believe in divine energies of the universe. So in last week, I do feel that there has been an opportunity which has come to my Cancerian friends, in which they have got an opportunity to move away from a person, place, or a situation that was toxic, that was causing them stress, that was more based on, you know, people involved in that situation were cheating on them. There was deception, there was manipulation in a certain situation. Now this can be with regard to your home, relationships, environment, or it can be with regard to your work area. But however, you have been able to, you know, move away from people who have been causing this distress in your life. So it can be also that your own energies were such that you were spying on a person, or might be there was a situation of manipulation and deception around you. Might be you were cheating on somebody, but however, with the divine intervention, you have been able to come out of this situation. That's what I feel in the coming week. So in the coming week, your energy vibrations are very, very beautiful. So the start of the week, I see you paying a lot of attention on yourself, giving yourself love, taking good care of your health, your regimes, might be visiting parlors, buying clothes for yourself, grounding yourself. Your mother, your partner becomes evidenced. And you need to surrender to stress, dear friends, in the coming week. You need to surrender all your stress and relax. So they say, take a few deep breaths and exhale the tension you've built up in your body. Let the stress go as you come back to your center. Beautiful energies. So start of the week, an opportunity of abundance, growth, expansion. If you want to manifest childbirth, it's a time frame of conception. If you're a mother, you are going to enjoy good gala time with your kids in the coming week. You or your mother becomes evident, a relationship with the mother-child becomes evident just on the start of the week, Monday, Tuesday. There is a healing in this relationship happening. I do feel that there is a blessing from a goddess also coming towards you on Monday, Tuesday. Tuesday, Wednesday, Seven of Cups, the energy of fantasies, dreaming, imagination, healing. So it's a very beautiful time frame for you. Many options are coming towards you. If you wanted to pursue a certain job, career, profession for yourself, I do see you seeking these options. I see you fantasizing. I see you dreaming and, you know, enjoying pleasurable time with your friends, family members. Thursday, Friday, the Sun card, your positivity, your yes answer, you enjoying with your children, with your partner, love is manifesting into your life. You are coming into limelight. It's a time frame of name, fame, recognition, affection, attention coming towards you. You paying attention to yourself and feeling that personal power. Towards the weekend, it is a time frame of judgment coming, a big judgment coming towards you from the angelic realm. It is a time frame of a rebirth for you. For some of my friends, this is an absolute rebirthing of you as a different individual as you awaken now to the universal energies. And this is a time frame when you are going to evaluate and re-evaluate your life with regard to your career, with regard to your relationships, with regard to your soul life purpose, and analyze people, places and situations. What is it that you want to pursue in your life? Who are those people you want to entertain in your life? Who are those people you want to discern? So big time frame of evaluation and re-evaluation. Very, very major arcana cards, three major arcana cards ending up in your reading tells me that it's a big time frame for you. And for many of you, this is a time frame of an opportunity coming back to you. Second time, this is a second chance being given to you from the universe of something that you wanted to manifest in your life, which did not happen for you before. And this is a week of manifestation for you. People from past of this life or past of any other life, I have started connecting towards you, giving you opportunities of growth, giving you opportunities, choices for your career, business, professions. And if you wanted to settle down in a married, committed relationship, or might be for you, your child, there were options you were looking for commitment. I do feel there are reconciliations in families, there are reconciliations in your marriages, there are choices, there is healing happening, and you are moving away from all that was causing you manipulations, cheating, deception, all that was unhealthy in your life is away from you now. Let me see what else they want to say. So this is a time frame of, you know, a lot of stability, security, organization coming into your life. For many of you all, your partner becomes evident. There can be a situation of healing around your partner, or an opportunity of upgrade or blessing coming for your partner, your children, that could be also there. However, the energies are very, very positive for you. There is going to be a dealing with a dark woman in the coming week. So now this woman, either she colors her hair in a very dark color, black or brown, or she is darker than you in her complexion. So there is going to be a dealing. So this woman can be a mother or a mother-like figure for you, can be your mother-in-law, can be your mother, or a woman in an authoritative position in a company or an institute or a government organization who is going to be of importance for you in the coming week. Can be a woman working at your home also. And wow, position of authority. So this position of authority comes to you, or might be for your partner or a child. I see a period of, as I was feeling, it's a period of growth, prosperity, positivity, Now you can start to fantasize whatever you wanted to pursue in your life. Those second chances have come in your favor. So it is a time frame of your yes answer. You are going to be talking to people in authoritative positions, might be your parents, might be people in authoritative positions are there who are going to be helping you in the manifestations of your desires. So zodiac signs which I see very, very evident for you in the coming week are Taurus, Cancer, Pisces, Scorpio, Leo, Sagittarius, Libra, Aquarius, Gemini. So these are the zodiac signs that are going to be evident for you, and you need to surrender to rest and sleep. So please relax yourself, relax your energies, take a break. A lot of manifestations of positivity is happening into your life, and for many of my friends this is happening because of the healings that you've taken. Might be we have been lucky to give you healings through our YouTube channel. So this positivity, this rebirth, these second chances opportunities are happening into your life. To prevent burnout, slow down. Honor your need for quiet time and peaceful sleep to rejuvenate your mind, body and spirit. Beautiful. So dear friends, in the coming week, the suggestion that comes across for you is to rest and sleep. So take your time, sleep, relax, rejuvenate your energies, and that's how these beautiful opportunities are about to manifest for you. It is a time frame of reconciliation in families, reconciliation in ex-lovers, ex-partners coming back into your life, reunions and opportunities of past coming back to you again. Big blessing coming from the divine. So lots of love to my Cancerian friends. Also, I want to say that while you're checking on this reading, I will be at Vaishno Devi temple. So if there is a wish, there is a desire that you want me to pray for you, so mention it down in the comment box below. I will be praying on your behalf to Vaishno Devi Mata Rani in the coming week. Lots of love and best wishes. So beautiful energies for our Cancerian friends. Let's cleanse the energies and move on to the next zodiac sign, that is the zodiac sign of Leo. And let's see how the coming week is going to be for our Leo friends. So far so good, all of the signs have been beautiful. So let us see the energy vibrations of the coming week for our Leo friends. So our Leo friends have been feeling discontented in life for some aspect of their life. In the coming week, there is a great opportunity of growth. There is a great opportunity of healing and clarity that is coming towards them. For many of my Leo friends, they are away from chaotic times now. A lot of healing has come towards them on their mental health. The stresses that they were going through, the anxiety that was all around them for my Leo friends. Now this can be with regard to your work area, or it can be with regard to your emotional state where you were feeling some kind of discontent. In the last week, I do feel that one chapter of your life is closing, and now you are going to head towards a new chapter of your life, which is going to bring you a lot of progress, which is going to bring you a lot of forward momentum. I do see travel for many of you in the coming week. I do feel that you are going to be traveling in the coming week, and this is a week of a lot of healing and love manifesting. My God, beautiful energies for you. So I've taken many cards. Let's see. So if you were seeking this reading with regard to your love or your partnership, I do feel that, you know, it is a time frame of a lot of emotional and mental healing for you, as you happen to manifest stability, security and forward momentum in your love relationships. I do see a Cancer, Pisces, Scorpio person, a Leo, Sagittarius, Libra, Aquarius person very evident for you. So if these are the zodiac signs of the people you're seeking love from, love is manifesting into your life. So there is going to be an opportunity of upgrade in your relationship. Okay, so beautiful energies. If you were concerned about the health and emotional health of a person, and I do feel that they are moving to there is some kind of a movement there is some kind of a travel, there is some kind of a clarity, a healing that is coming towards them in the coming week. So yes, there is going to be healing in their emotional health and their mental health in the coming week. If you were seeking this reading with regard to your career, profession or business, I do feel that, you know, there is going to be an opportunity of a new career or a project that is coming towards you, which can be involving travel to another city, state or a country, which is an opportunity of an upgrade for you. A lot of name, fame, recognition is going to head towards you in the coming week. So very beautiful energies for my Leo friends in the coming week. Just the start of the week with the Ace of Swords, a lot of clarity coming towards you. Now this clarity can come from a lawyer, from a judge, from a doctor or from the divine realm. An idea, an inspiration is coming towards you to start up something new or to bring clarity in your situation. Mid of the week, Six of Swords tells me that might be you're traveling on Wednesday, Thursday. Might be there is a communication of healing. There is an offer. There is a middle person involved in this situation who helps you heal from a chaotic situation in your life. So now this can be a lawyer, this can be a doctor, this can be a healer. Or any middle person that I said, Cancer, Pisces, Scorpio, Aquarius, Libra, a person can be involved in this situation who brings this healing for you. And this is an opportunity of travel for many of my friends in their work environment towards the weekend. Queen of Cups, you are being nurtured by a very beautiful person around you. Now this can be your partner, your mother or your daughter, a nurturing person around you, or it can be your own energies that you're nurturing and healing other people around you. This can be energy of a psychic person, a healer. So in this week, I do feel that, you know, either you are a healer yourself and you're healing yourself and healing other people around you, or it is the energy of a person around you who is giving healing to you and taking you out of all the chaotic times. So if you were wishing for a certain opportunity to manifest for you, might be a commitment in your relationship. May is the month that has been highlighted. May 2022 becomes evident for you, for your love manifestation, for your new job, travel. Wow, amazing energies for you. A wish is granted for my Leo friends. Manifest whatever you wanted to manifest for yourself, my dear Leo friends. And a younger woman becomes evident for you. So there is going to be a dealing or a relationship with a younger woman in the coming week for you. Very, very beautiful energies for my Leo friends. Lot of calming energies, lot of mental clarity, lot of emotional peace that I see for you in the coming week. So enjoy yourself thoroughly well, my Leo friends. It's a very beautiful week of healing for you and a wish fulfillment for you. And also want to tell my Leo friends that while you are watching this reading, I will be traveling and visiting Goddess Vaishno Devi. So if there is a wish, there is a desire that you want to pray from Goddess, you can comment it down below in the comment box and I will be praying on your behalf. And there are some beautiful cards that have popped out for you, and let us see what they say. So they say, surrender your belief of scarcity. So if there have been situations in past where you felt scarce in any area of your life, be it for your profession, for your goals, your opportunities, scarcities of opportunities or scarcity of love or child manifestation might be in your life. So they say, surrender that belief. The universe is asking you to open to the infinite nature of abundance. In this way, you can remove blocks in your life and succeed beyond your wildest dreams. Beautiful energies for you. So universe has an abundance of everything. So you just need to give your wish, your desire to the universe and it will be blessed for you. Universe is not scarce for anybody. Surrender your attachment to results. So whatever area of your life you're working on, you need to surrender your attachments with the results and you'll see how soon this opportunity manifests for you. And they are hinting on the month of May. The formula for success is to do all you can to make things happen, then let go of the results. Holding on too tightly to a desired outcome can sabotage it. So surrender your attachment to results and believe that whatever you're working on is going to manifest for you. It is a week of a big wish fulfillment for my Leo friends. So lots of love and best wishes to you. Enjoy yourself thoroughly well in the coming week. One new chapter of your life is beginning with a lot of accomplishment. Wishing you all the best. Lots of love and best wishes to my Leo friends. So now let us move on to our next zodiac sign and see the energy vibrations of the coming week for our beautiful zodiac sign of Virgo, and let us see how the coming week is going to be for our Virgo friends. So far so good, beautiful energies for all of our zodiac signs. Let us see. So our Virgo friends have been working on themselves and being blessed on their relationships, have been in a very supreme power. Goddesses are working on them. So the coming week looks very, very beautiful and dynamic for them. So they have been able to release a few of relations from their life which were toxic, which were ego based. In the last week, I do feel that you have taken the healing of cord cuttings via goddess Gaia or via goddess Kali, and you have released many toxic relationships from your life. Many people who were ego based are far from you now. And you are manifesting opportunities of growth, abundance, success. And you have started giving yourself love in the last week. That's what I'm feeling. So Monday, Tuesday itself, with the card of Ten of Swords, there is going to be a situation of the end of all that was toxic, the end of all that was painful in your life, the end of all that was causing you. The people that were backstabbing you, the people that were causing you a lot of pain in your body, in your chakras, that all those blocked energies in your chakras or all those toxic cords that were attached with you are going to be released in the coming week with the card of Ten of Swords. I do feel that this is a sword of these are swords of Archangel Michael, these are swords of Goddess Kali, these are swords of divine realm, cutting the cords of negativity that were attached with you or from this life or past life, releasing you of the toxic relationship situations in your life. So there is an end of a painful life cycle for you just at the start of the week itself, Monday, Tuesday, and you will feel much more relaxed in your energies ever after. So there is a rebirth happening for you in the mid of the week, Wednesday, Thursday. The energy of Sun card tells me that, you know, something very toxic has ended in your life. Your energy is rejuvenated and now the positivity enters your life. This is a time frame of positivity. This is a time frame of your yes answers, your opportunities of growth, your time of you coming into personal power. You gaining your self-esteem, your self-respect back. All eyes on you, name, fame, recognition, affection, attention, appreciation coming towards you in the mid of the week. Now this can be with regard to your child also, some of you manifesting your childbirth. So if you had lost a child via miscarriage in past, this conception of this child is going to happen for you in the coming week. Yes, so this is a week of you releasing your ego, your control, and believing in the divine. This is a week of you becoming organized. This is a week of you performing your tasks in a very, very methodological What is it? Methodly, okay. I'm not being able to pronounce that word somehow. So, monotonously, okay, maybe you're doing everything in a very organized manner. Towards the weekend, I see you traveling. I see like-minded people coming towards you, partnerships heading towards you. You getting options to travel. You're getting options to explore more opportunities of self-growth for might be your passions, your work area, your creativity, your jobs, your career perspectives. There are new opportunities coming for you. I do see that you are on a solid ground, but there are new opportunities of growth coming for you. So I do feel that, you know, this is a time frame when a person in position, there is a certain person in position, can be your partner also, or can be a parent, or a person in a position in a company who gives you an opportunity of growth, expansion, travel also. And there is an end of very tiresome period for you, which was ego based, which was not leading to any kind of growth for you. That's what I feel. Yes. So there is going to be a dealing with a dark woman in the coming week. So dealing or relationship with a woman with dark complexion or hair becomes evident for you in the coming week. So this woman can be a woman in an authoritative position, or might be she has hair on a darker color, or might be her complexion is darker than you. And affairs with your family are going to be evident for you in the coming week. So somewhere the affairs with your family becomes evident for you. Yes, I do see your mother. I do see a female figure, your partner, somebody becoming evident for you in the coming week. Surrender to the beauty of natural world. Wow, beautiful, beautiful energies for you. So you must be, you are being guided to connect with Gaia, with Mother Earth. Take a relaxing break and spend time in nature. Replenish yourself by feeling the beauty and the ecstasy there. Wow, so go for a walk in your gardens. Enjoy yourself. In the coming week, I do feel that some kind of an upgrade is happening for you in the coming week with your central energy of the Sun card. Your health is rejuvenating. You are attaining back your personal power, and that is very beautiful. So also want to tell my Virgo friends over here that, you know, while you will be listening to this reading, I am going to be visiting Goddess Vaishno Devi. So if there is a desire, if there is a wish that you want the goddess to fulfill for you, comment down below in the comment box, write it down, and I will be praying on your behalf, and I'll be visiting her while you're going through this reading. So wish you all the best, my Virgo friends. So beautiful energies for our Virgo friends also. And so let us move further to the next zodiac sign, that is the zodiac sign of Libra, and let us see how the coming week is going to be for our Libran friends. So dear angels, what are the energy vibrations of the coming week for our Libran friends? So our Libran friends have been traveling, some of them have been progressing in their life, working in team, and being appreciated by their partners, by their colleagues, have started giving themselves a lot of love. And so the opportunities of growth, leadership are manifesting into their life. Okay. So for my Libran friends, if you were seeking an opportunity to move away from people, places, and situations that were causing you a lot of deception, a lot of cheating or manipulation, an opportunity of upgrade comes to you. This is a slow moving opportunity where you can make your escape from these situations. towards another city, state or a country also might be, and move away from people, places and situation that cause you a lot of distress. That's what I feel. So in last week, this energy has, you know, has been around you. So in the coming week, I see very, very beautiful energies for you. First of all, definitely, I do feel that, you know, most of the people who are listening to this reading are healers or card readers or psychic occults. It is a very, very fantabulous week for my friends who are spiritual by nature. I do see that the angelic realm is very well connected with you. And there is a lot of passion. There is a lot of creativity. There is a lot of healing happening. You are becoming dynamic in your energies. You have this very, very high positive energy vibrating through you, which is the energy of the angelic realm, which is the energy of positivity, which is the energy of dynamism, which is the energy of a leader, a charismatic, positive superstar that you're vibrating through you. So not just for spiritual friends, for all of my Libran friends who are listening to this reading, I do feel that, you know, there is a new energy entering your body. Your sacral chakra has been healed. There is an opportunity of leadership, an opportunity that comes to you of growth, of pursuing your passion, of doing something that you feel is impossible for you, that you might not have ever done in your life. But the universal realm and the angelic realm is saying that you are ready for this opportunity. You are ready to manifest growth, abundance, leadership. It is the time frame for you to come into the limelight now. Because the angelic energies, your ascended masters, your deceased loved ones are very well connected with you. There are people from your spirit family, high vibrational beings, your ancestors who are by your side, who are in your aura, guiding you through and through these opportunities of growth that are coming towards you. Okay? So there is a big change, there is a big shift that is heading into the life of my Libran friends. And all during this period of change and shift, I see a Sagittarius, Leo, Aries person very, very evident around you. Now this person, either this person is a person in a position of authority, and this is a person who brings this opportunity of growth, spiritual growth and passionate growth for you in your work, career, business, profession, or this is your own energies that you are in a very fiery energies. You are in an energy of a Leo, Sagittarius, Aries person, fiery energies. You have the command of your life in your hand now, and you are absolutely dynamic, charismatic to manifest whatever you want to manifest for yourself at this time frame. So if there is an opportunity that you want to travel, they are telling me, oh my god, so if there is an opportunity that you want to manifest for yourself that involves a move to another city, state or a country, grab that opportunity and make the most of it. Any passion that you want to pursue, it's a beautiful time frame. If you were seeking love and compassion, settlement, if you're seeking this reading for building on a relationship with a partner who might be younger to you, and this relationship, there can be some kind of a manipulation or a deception in the relationship, something of the sorts that is happening. I do feel that, you know, you will be finally deciding to, you know, either end your committed relationship with a partner and move towards this partner who is giving you more passion in your life, or you are going to end a deceptive relationship that was not building into any future. If there is a court case that you're fighting, if there is an involvement of a lawyer, a judge, I do feel a situation of peace, harmony, mediation happening wherein, a peaceful resolution is going to come in your favor. Now let's see. Deep personal strength and peace that assures success. So success is yours in any area of your life. You're coming into limelight. That's what I feel. Happiness. Wow. It's a time frame of a lot of happiness manifesting into your life, my Libran friends. Surrender to wonder and awe. And over here also with the orange and yellow, red color, orange, yellow, red color, orange. Your divine feminine is healed. Your divine feminine is opening up for receiving now. So it is a time frame of the healing of your sacral chakra, solar plexus chakra, your root chakra, opening up for abundance, healing, receiving from the universe now for my Libran friends. So they say open to the magic of every moment and sense the awe and wonder in all of life. This attitude will keep you connected to the ecstasy of flow. So go with the flow of the things that are coming towards you. That's the message coming across. So everything that is manifesting into your life, everything that is coming towards you, you might feel a bit shaky, as if, you know, your confidence might be feeling at times that, you know, is it for my good? Am I good enough? Yes, you are good enough. Happiness is manifesting into your life. You have been giving a lot. It is a time frame of receiving for my Libran friends. Open up yourself for receiving from the divine realm, from your ancestors, from your deceased loved ones, in whatever area of your life that you want to pursue, that you're seeking in. It is a time frame of an upgrade, you taking leadership roles, you taking back your power and control. So I see a very, very strong, a power couple emerging over here. So if there is a person who is heading towards, if you're single and you're heading towards a relationship, this is a power couple. This is a relationship of a power couple. So wishing you all the best. Beautiful time frame for my Libran friends. And so I also want to tell my Libran friends that while you are going through this reading, I am at Vaishno Devi visiting Goddess Vaishno Mata. So if there is a wish, there is a desire that you want to pray to Goddess Vaishno Devi, comment down below in the comment box and I will be praying on your behalf since I'm already here. So lots of love and best wishes to my dear friends, Libran friends. Beautiful week for you. A lot of personal power, popularity coming towards you. Enjoy yourself thoroughly well. So let us cleanse the energies and move on to the next zodiac sign. That is the zodiac sign of Scorpio. And let us see how the coming week is going to be for our Scorpio friends. So dear angels, so far so good. What are the energy vibrations of the coming week for our Scorpion friends? Let us see the energy vibrations of the coming week for our Scorpion friends. Very dynamic, very charismatic energies for our Scorpion friends. I want to understand if this card wants to be upright or it wants to fall. Okay, so I'm going to take it like this. Wow. So there is a very, very tiresome cycle ending in their life. So all the situations that were ego-based, that were based on a win-win kind of a situation, are going to be released. So if there were people around you who were giving you a lot of stress, or there was a situation that was causing you a lot of stress, there is going to be a release of that situation. And this is happening because of a big blessing coming towards you from a divine goddess or a woman around you. This can be your mother, this can be your partner, this can be a mother-like woman who is blessing you, who is helping you cut the cords of negativities from your body and releasing you from all that was negative, from all that was toxic in your life. So in the coming week, a situation that was held back is going to come to an end. There is going to be a release of a lot many burdens, might be for you or might be for a person around you who who is a Leo, Sagittarius, Aries, Taurus, Virgo, Libra, or a Scorpion person. That's what I feel. Okay. So the start of the week with the King of Rods, you are feeling dynamic. You're like a superstar. There is an opportunity of leadership, an opportunity, a work opportunity to pursue your passions. You might feel that, you know, you are not good enough to pursue these passions, but the divine realm is saying that you are good enough. You can pursue the relationships, these passions. So all those unhealthy relationships are going to be surrendered. So your guidance message over here says, surrender unhealthy relationships, let go of relationships that don't serve you, including unavailable or toxic people. You deserve to be treasured by others and be surrounded by positive people. So let go of toxic people. I do feel that a relationship with a toxic narcissist person is going to end in the last week. It has ended. An egoistic situation might be. Mid of the week, you release a lot many burdens. So if you were working on a certain project or you were feeling tiresome in your body, mind and soul, that energy is released from your body. And for many of my friends, this is a major release from your root chakra. Yeah, something from your past life, the attachments from your past lives which were toxic for you are going to be released in the mid of the week. And thereafter, from Thursday, Friday, Saturday, Sunday, Ace of Rods, a new relationship is heading into your life, a new passion, a start of new passion, work, career, or a new relationship manifesting into your life. So you need to have patience. You need to see your life and people with a different perspective in the coming week. And many of you are being guided to do yogas, meditations in the coming week to make this major release from your body in order to rejuvenate yourself and invite the energies of abundance in all areas of your life. Yes, so something toxic ending, might be a toxic environment in your work is ending, might be you had a communication with a senior person. And so your burdens are ending and there is a new start that is happening for you in the coming week. So there is going to be a relationship with a younger man. There is going to be a dealing with a younger man in the coming week. They say dealing or relationship with a younger man. So this man can be having long hair, might be. Bridge, successful outcome to a problem. So beautiful energy. So whatever situation that you were stressed about a lot, there is going to be an end to that situation in the coming week. Surrender to your creativity. Wow. So this is beautiful. I feel that, you know, you are going to pursue a creative passion, a creative project. There is going to be a start of a very creative venture in the coming week for you. Might be you are starting yoga meditations, some spiritual practice also. Let your imagination soar. Stay open to all creative ideas about how to pursue a dream or solve a problem. So exactly over here also, you are going to get creative ideas, intuition, successful outcome to a problem and a dream to solve a problem. So as you open yourself to your creative abilities, you solve all your problems. So if there were any problems with regard to a younger man, that will be also solved in the coming week. So I wish you all the best. My Scorpion friends, also want to tell my Scorpion friends here that while you are checking on this reading, I will be traveling. I will be in Goddess Vaishno Devi's Darbar. And if there is a wish, if there is a pray that you want to save to Vaishno Devi Matarani, you can comment it down below and I will be praying on your behalf since I'm already here. So lots of love and best wishes to you. So beautiful energy is for my Scorpion friends also. Let's move forward and see the energy vibrations of the coming week for our Sagittarius friends. So dear angels, let us see the energy vibrations of the coming week for our Sagittarius friends. So our Sagittarius friends are working very hard. Some kind of an upgrade is on their mind. There is a Taurus, Virgo, Capricorn person, Cancer, Pisces, Scorpio person on their mind. So the energies of a partner, of a mother, okay, becomes very evident. A mother-child relationship. Okay, so what are the energy vibrations? Let's see. So in the last week, there has been an opportunity. A certain good news has come to our Sagittarius friends in the last week. They have felt a lot of healing and rejuvenation on in their energies. Might be you were in dealing with a doctor, with a lawyer, with a person who gave you a lot of clarity in a certain situation. This can be a healer also. So this person gave you a certain good news in last week, and this good news can be with regard to your partner, your parent, or a committed relationship. Might be your in-laws, or might be a person in a senior person in a senior position, I feel, and in an authoritative position. Or might be there was an adventurous activity that you were doing. Might be you were traveling with your children, or a news, good news on behalf of your child has come to you in the last week. I feel you've been very adventurous. You've healed yourself in the last week. In the coming week, I do see very, very strong energies for you. Just the start of the week, there is a big blessing which is coming towards you from a goddess. It can be a blessing from your mother, your parent also, or your partner. So with the energies of the Empress, there is an opportunity of growth, expansion, child manifestation, fertility. You looking very dynamic, very attractive, attracting a lot many people of opposite sex towards you, giving yourself love Monday, Tuesday, and beautifying yourself and taking good care of yourself and people around you. Very dynamic, charismatic energies where you feel like an empress, and definitely vibrating at an energy of a lot of abundance. Beautiful energies. Your mother becomes evident, your children become evident during this time frame. Mid of the week, with the card of the Hierophant, a certain authoritative institute or a company, might be a school, a big organization, government organization, person in a very authoritative position, might be your parent, your partner, your in-laws, a head in a company, becomes evident for you in this this time frame, and a blessing from them can come to you during this time frame. Towards the weekend, I do feel some challenging energies. This can be an a misunderstanding within a family, where the members of the family are not on the same pace, or it can be a challenging competitive kind of a situation in your work area where you are feeling a bit of stress towards the weekend. I do feel that's the energy. There is a big change heading towards you in the coming week. There is an end of a situation, and I do feel that this situation involves somebody who is in an authoritative position. Okay, let's see what else is there. So there is going to be a dealing with an arrogant, boastful person you should not cross. So this can happen towards the weekend. So there is an arrogant, boastful person. This person can be Leo, Sagittarius, Aries, Taurus. Yes, this person can be Taurus, Leo, Sagittarius, Aries person, and this person is an arrogant person whom you should not be crossing. So if there is a situation of conflict with them, you better is to stay away from them. A wish being granted. Exactly. I did feel that, you know, from the start of the week till the mid of the week, or towards, you know, say Friday, a big wish is going to be granted. If there was a favor you were seeking from a big organization, like, you know, government organizations, visa approvals or some kind of approvals you were waiting from big organizations, that approval comes in your favor in the coming week. And if there was healing that you were seeking for your mother, your parents, your partners, and your commitments, or with regard to health of a person, I do feel that a very big wish is granted for you. Surrender to miracles. Beautiful energies for our Sagittarius friends. Be open to miracles occurring in your life. Feel and know that these events are real. Wow. Let go of any resistance and banish any doubt that miracles can happen. So very miraculous situation around you in the coming week. A big blessing coming on your parents, your commitments with your partners, your in-laws, your children. So a wish is granted, a big blessing from big companies. If you wanted to manifest an opportunity of upgrade in your work area, that blessing, a growth in your business or a new profession, you becoming a spiritual healer or a teacher, there is a blessing coming from a spiritual person, a spiritual institute. I do feel a blessing from Vaishno Devi is coming towards you. And also want to tell my Sagittarius friends that while you are going through this reading, I am in Vaishno Devi, so you can comment down below your prayers to Mata, your wishes to Mata, and I will be praying on your behalf for the manifestations of these desires. It is the manifestation of marriage for many of my friends. It is the manifestation of childbirth. A good news coming towards you. I do feel that all of the competition and challenges are behind you, and you can expect miracles in the coming week, my Sagittarius friends. A very beautiful week for our Sagittarius friends. A big time blessing coming from divine goddesses, your ancestors, your deceased loved ones. So wishing you all the best. Enjoy yourself thoroughly well in the coming week. So let's cleanse the energies and move towards the next zodiac sign. That is the zodiac sign of Capricorn. And let us see how the coming week is going to be for our Capricorn friends. Let us see the energy vibrations of the coming week for our Capricorn friends. Okay. So what are the energy vibrations? I do feel that an opportunity of soulful joy from a person in an authoritative position has come to my Capricorn friends in last week only. Justice is in their favor. Wow. One new chapter of their life is beginning with a lot of accomplishment. All that was negative in their life is being released. In the last week, all that was stressful, all that was chaotic, all that was causing you a lot of anxiety has been released. There has been time of a lot of soulful joy, happiness that you have experienced in the last week. There has been an opportunity of education, of upgrade, of success, of you know, travel might be, or stability, security that has manifested in your life that is coming towards you in the coming week. So all your karmic rewards are coming towards you. A new chapter of your life is beginning, can be for you or can be for your child. I do feel that an opportunity of studying abroad, if that is what you were seeking for, an educative opportunity or a work opportunity for you or your child is manifesting for you. I do see travel in the coming week. I do see an involvement with a lawyer, a doctor or a judge. A lot of clarity coming towards you. I do see a Cancer, Pisces, Scorpio person, an Aquarius person, a Libra person, and a Virgo, Taurus, Capricorn person evident for you in the coming week. So the start of the week itself, you get an opportunity of expansion, of stability, security, of financial benefit, of education, of childbirth, if that's what you wanted to manifest. Mid of the week, balancing of energies, balancing of your physical body also. You doing a lot, many exercising and feeling balanced in your mental and physical body. Dealings with lawyers, judges, karmic rewards coming towards you, justice coming in your favor. Towards the end of the week, a big achievement, a big life chapter closing, you moving on to the next life chapter. For many of my friends, these can be court marriages, this can be achievements and upgrade in your work area, an opportunity of growth. Love manifesting, love and marriage manifesting, harmonious relationships manifesting, choices being given to you. Okay. You will be shown the way. Yeah, beautiful energy is for you. So a lot of divine guidance. You will be shown the way. Dog barking, advice from a friend is coming towards you. This friend can be in a far off place also, might be a traveling. Yes, the boat card. I did feel that an opportunity of movement, travel can manifest in your life. And for many of my other friends, money or property through an inheritance, winning or windfall. Wow. So it's a time frame of an upgrade. A financial benefit is coming towards you through inheritance. Might be in the mid of the week, your parents are writing, giving you in something in documentation. Or winning or a windfall gain is coming towards you from your work area, might be. So there are opportunities of travel also. Somebody is traveling towards you or you are traveling. Surrender to passion. So very beautiful energies for our Capricorn friends. So they say, get out of your head and feel the fire in your belly. Wow. So get out of your head, that is, you know, get out of all the negative thinking patterns that you were having. Focus on the people or activities that ignite your passion and let it flow. Beautiful energies for you. Get out of your head and feel the fire in your belly. Focus on the people or activities that ignite your passion and let it flow. So this is not a minor week for my Capricorn friends. A major lifetime justice and balance coming for you. So enjoy yourself thoroughly well, my Capricorn friends. Lots of love and best wishes to you. So I see an opportunity which will make you very overwhelmed. And also want to tell my Capricorn friends that I will be in Vaishno Devi while you're checking on this reading. So you can comment down below your prayers, your wishes that you want to be granted from Vaishno Mata, and I'll be praying on your behalf since I'm already here in Vaishno Devi. Lots of love and best wishes to you. Great, so far so good. So let us move on to the next zodiac sign, that is the zodiac sign of Aquarius, and let us see how the coming week is going to be for our Aquarian friends. Let us see the energy vibrations of the coming week for our Aquarian friends. So our Aquarian friends have been contemplating a change, waiting on a change, and in divine timing, this change is going to manifest for them. That's the message coming across. And they have worked really hard. They are wishing for love, new love, opportunities of healing. They have felt a lot of lack in their life, either of emotional satisfaction, love, or of a certain desire that they wanted to manifest for themselves. Emotionally, they have felt lack in their life. Might be they have felt lack in their relationships with their children, their parents, their partners. There have been scenarios of fights in past, and they are feeling in the coming week, Monday, Tuesday, I feel that, you know, you are feeling as though you have given 200% in a certain relationship, or might be a certain work scenario, and you're wishing for changes, you're wishing for your results. There is an involvement of a court also over here, a lawyer, a judge that I see for you. In the mid of the week, I see a situation of some kind of a mediation happening, wherein there is a situation of, you know, mutual understanding or mediation that is happening, a peaceful situation that is occurring. If you were going through some court cases, and towards the end of the week, I see you traveling, or a person who is very passionate about you, who loves you, who is a friend, moving towards you, traveling towards you, communicating with you. This person can be younger to you in age, I do feel, or might be you are traveling, meeting up, having communications with them. So if you're seeking this reading for love and relationship, I do feel that you have felt a lot of lack in your relationships in past, and there is healing occurring in the relationship. There are new offers of love coming towards you, and this change is going to manifest for you in divine timing. That's what they are telling me. So yeah, so this is a time frame of growth, prosperity, abundance for you. It's a time frame of movement also for many of my friends. There is a residential move being planned for you to another city, state or a country. And for many of my friends, if you're seeking this opportunity for financial growth, travel and movement, or to pursue your divine passion, if you want to become a spiritual healer or a teacher, and that's the passion you want to pursue, I feel that divine realm is connecting with you. And yes, there are going to be opportunities of healing that will come towards you in the coming week. For many of my other friends in their work environment, in their career, business, profession, I do feel that an opportunity of movement, travel, change has come to you, but it will manifest for you in divine timing, and it will be for your growth. It will be in your favor. Yes, exactly. New job or career opportunity. I do feel that this involves travel. Yes, this blessing will come to you in the coming week. Protection from a powerful friend. I do feel you have a spirit animal, a dog, or might be this is the protection from a very strong spiritual person around you, or your spirit animal can be a dog who is there in heaven protecting you. Anyhow, I do feel that angelic energies are very well connected for you. So mid of the week, lot of patience, peace. You are going with the flow. You are in control or in balance of your energies. There is a Sagittarius person who becomes evident. Cancer, Pisces, Scorpio, Virgo, Capricorn, Taurus. These are the zodiac signs evident for you in the coming week. Towards the weekend, very, very passionate energies. You enjoying with your friends. Flirting, having gossiping, traveling, that kind of an energy vibration. So beautiful time frame for you. If you wanted to manifest childbirth, it will happen for you in divine timing. There is no need to worry. I do feel that in the Sagittarius season, a conception of child can take place for you. Surrender obsessive thinking. That is the guidance coming for you. So whatever lack you have felt in life, you need to surrender obsessive thinking, they say. If you're obsessing about a person or situation, turn the dilemma over to spirit. Doing so will bring you clarity or even solve the problem. If you're obsessing about a person or situation, turn the dilemma over to spirit. Doing so will help bring you clarity or even solve the problem. So beautiful energy. So surrender your obsessive thinking with regard to a situation or a person. As you are protected by angelic realm, divine energies are by your side. And just as you surrender this obsessive thinking, your relaxed energies are going to attract positive opportunities towards you. So also want to tell my Aquarius friends that while you're having a glance at this reading, I am in Vaishno Devi, visiting Goddess Vaishno Devi. So if there is a wish, there is a prayer that you want to make to the Goddess, you can comment it down in the comment box below, and I will be praying on your behalf since I'm already here with Mata Rani. So wish you all the best, lots of love and best wishes. So let us cleanse the energy and move towards the last zodiac sign, that is the zodiac sign of Pisces, and let us see how the coming week is going to be for our Piscean friends. So what are the energy vibrations of the coming week? So I do feel that our Piscean friends are traveling or planning a move, or there is a certain passion that they want to pursue. They are wishing for soulmate relationships. They are wishing for reconciliations. So let us see, what are the energy vibrations? Okay. So last week, my Piscean friends have felt very, very satisfied in their energy. So there have been opportunities of financial upgrade. There have been opportunities of stability, security in their life that they have felt. A destiny shift which has made them feel very, very grounded in their energies. There have been situations of wish fulfillment for them. So in the coming week, my Piscean friends are being suggested to cut their cords from people, places and situations which are toxic. And as the first message coming across, so do take that healing of Kali Mata to cut your cords from the people, places and situations that are toxic for you, and defend your energy from draining people. From people who drain your energies, you defend your energies from them. Okay, so start of the week, I see you spying on a certain person, on a certain situation. I do feel that an opportunity, a certain email, a certain phone call or a chat or a documentation work is happening for you in the start of the week, Monday, Tuesday itself, and you are very, very defensive, fighting your last battles to manifest a certain opportunity for you. Now this opportunity can be with regard to love, it can be with regard to relationship scenario or a work scenario. Surrender to divine timing is the message coming across, and you are being very protective about your lover also. I do feel that, you know, you are defending yourself or protecting yourself from being spied, might be from a lover, from a partner who is younger to you in age, something of the sorts. That's what I feel. Or there is a younger person around you, can be your child, can be your brother, younger brother. That's the energy. So I do feel that an opportunity of financial benefit, stability, security in a relationship has come to you. But this is a slow moving energy, and they are saying you need to surrender to the divine timing for the manifestation of this desire. And I do see that you are very defensive about this opportunity or this person. You need to relax your energies, and this is a time frame of karmic rewards that are coming, and they will come in your favor soon. Mid of the week, I see you fighting your battles, being very defensive, standing your ground, speaking your truth. Towards the end of the week, I do see an opportunity of upgrade, stability, security, you performing your tasks with a lot of responsibility. That's what I feel. And the zodiac signs that are evident over here are Sagittarius, Taurus, Aquarius, Libra, Gemini, Cancer, Pisces, Scorpio. Successful outcome to a problem. Yes, so if there was a problem that you were really fighting for, there is going to be a successful outcome, a journey, either physical or mental. Yes, I do feel that, you know, some of you are going to be traveling or manifesting a journey in the coming week. Surrender to your intuition. Tune in. Here are some bells ringing over here, so it can be a time frame of celebration or a big blessing coming to you. Surrender to your intuitions. I feel some of you are hearing ringing bells in your ears. That is the signal that the angels are giving their messages to you. Tune into your inner voice. Be aware of any gut feelings, flashes, knowings or ahas, moments that come through to guide you. So your intuitive messages are coming towards you, giving you clarity about the situation that you want to manifest for you, the relationships or the opportunities of work that are coming towards you that you want. You are very, very possessive, obsessive about these opportunities. They will manifest for you in the divine timing. Also want to tell my Piscean friends that, you know, When you're listening to this reading at this time, I am in Vaishno Devi, so you can comment down below about your desire, your wish, your prayers to Mata Rani, and I will be praying on your behalf. So I wish you all the best, lots of love and best wishes to my Piscean friends, and lots of love and best wishes to all of my friends here on Healing Souls. Wish you a very, very blessed, beautiful week ahead. Enjoy yourself thoroughly well. Thank you very much, dear friends.